So I'm really a fan of testing, because if someone has Lyme disease plus Bartonella, the protocol for success is very different than if they have Lyme disease plus Babesia, or if they have Lyme disease plus mycoplasma, or if you have these three or four things. I mean, we had one patient in this last week, we found four things on. And so you're not gonna be as successful if you're blind to, you know, what exactly this person has, because Babesia is a protozoa parasite. You're not gonna kill it with antibacterials aimed at Lyme disease. Bartonella is a bacteria that hides inside the cell and doesn't move. Well, Lyme disease is one of the few bacteria that's so fast, it can swim upstream against your blood supply. It can go up the river. So trying to pin down Lyme disease or Borrelia is like playing tag with someone who's like Usain Bolt faster than you. And then trying to catch Bartonella is like someone who's playing hide and seek. So the strategies for playing hide and seek and playing tag with Usain Bolt and then doing a parasite, which is just like an alien thrown in the mix, are completely different. So if you're trying to just do a general kind of shotgun approach, that's very hard if you have some of these different organisms, because you really need different strategies to help people heal from each one.
Even from an antibiotic perspective?
Yeah, this is a good question, is people go, well, what about antibiotics and this? So when we talk about Lyme disease, there's various antibiotic protocols out there. We've gone over this before, about 80% of patients in our clinic are doing this without medications, without antibiotics. About 20% of people end up using antibiotics as part of their protocol. So the trouble you get into is the antibiotics for Lyme and Bartonella are a little bit different. I'm actually pretty strong of the opinion that Bartonella is probably the disease that I see antibiotics fail for the most. And I think this is because Bartonella hides inside the cell and then creates like a special safe zone inside the cell. So what they're trying to do with antibiotics is they're trying to get this deep tissue penetration, because you have to get the antibiotic into your cell and then into the membrane inside your cell. And then once you're there, you have to get it through the membrane of the Bartonella. So we tell people it's like five layers deep. You're trying to get this antibiotic into the Bartonella so it can kill it. I think this is the hardest way to kill Bartonella, and we find much better success with a lot of our Bartonella patients doing a little bit different strategy, where we're trying to help get the Bartonella out of the cell. So I think this is kind of a hallmark case where functional medicine comes in really well. If you can get your body to help boot the Bartonella out of its safety zone, we think it's much more successful than trying to dive deep into the cells for most people. And also, this is why I think we see more side effects with Bartonella protocols, is because trying to get antibiotics that deep into the system create just an absolute havoc of side effects for a lot of patients. Whenever we're doing Bartonella, the picture that I show people is a little safe. So I have them remember, so Bartonella's in the cell, in the safe. And in order to really get at the Bartonella, you need to pull it out of the safe. One of the analogies I tell my patients is, if you've got something hidden in your basement in the safe, and you're gonna try to destroy what's in the safe, a drive-by shooting is not a good method. You're gonna destroy your whole house, and you're probably not gonna hurt the thing in the basement in the safe. So we really think the best way with Bartonella is to be doing things that help the cell kick the Bartonella out, and then it's vulnerable. We really don't think Bartonella is that difficult to get if you've got it out of its protective zone. If you can catch these things right away, it's always much easier. But once it's in the safe, best way to do is try to get it out of the safe rather than dive into the safe with it.